This is chapter number 6, New Questions and Ideas. Here we are going to take extra important questions, MCQ type, multiple choice, true, false, you know, all these we would like to cover whole of the chapter. These pictures are very important. We are going to cover them and come back whenever it is required. Why did farmers could not support Jainism? Now, the situation was Mahavirji, Jain Dharma. So the teachings were, whoever is going to be a follower, they are not going to kill anyone. No killing. Every living being wants to live. They have a desire to live. So you cannot kill anyone. That's what Jainism is all about. But the farmers, the problem was that the insects, which are, you can say, killing the crop or destroying the crop, they have to kill them. So the traders, Vyapari merchants, they took the Jainism, you know, easily. But the farmers, because of this reason, they cannot take this so easily. So farmers had to kill insects to protect their crops. This is the reason. Because the cultivation, you know, all these things are required. Weedicides, pesticides, all these they have to use. Where is Vallabhi situated? Vallabhi is in Gujarat. Vallabhi is in Gujarat. So whatever we are getting, you can say the teaching or the content of Jain or Jain teachings is here we have Gujarat. And there we have Vallabhi. There we get Jain, Sankalan. Both Mahavira and Buddha felt that only those who left their homes can gain true knowledge. And this is absolutely correct. Both of them said that if you want to attain enlightenment, you want to get truth or satya, you have to come out of your homes, that is, leave the comfort of the house. What was the name of the association of those who left their homes? So when, you know, Buddha and Mahavira teaching, they said that if you want to get truth, want truth, you have to leave home. So those who leave home, where are they going to stay? So that association were termed as Sangha. Sangha. Those who are followers, they come and live in Sangha. Now, the next question is, name the book in which the rules made for the Buddhist Sangha were written down. See, whatever we are learning, we are getting it from some inscription, from some evidence or some books. So, this is Vinaya Pitaka. Vinaya Pitaka. This is the book in which the rules made for the Buddhist Sangha. We find out, we get it from here. All this is written down here. Vinaya Pitaka. What was the Vanaprastha stage? So, there were four stages in Sanatan. The initial is Brahmacharya. It means complete celibacy. No sex. Then, that is, the next one is Grihastha Ashram. That means reproduction, getting married to a woman and creating child. So that is a Grihastha. Then we have Vanaprastha Ashram, going to forest, meditating, and then finally the Sannyas Ashram. So the stage that emphasized, third one, emphasized meditation and life in the forest. This is Vanaprastha stage, Vanaprastha Ashram. Buddha was approached by a woman to bring back the life of her deceased son. What was the name of the lady? So, the name, before the name, let me tell you the story. A woman was there and her kid died. And it's very difficult for any woman if either men or women, if their kid die, they are going to die. Means emotionally they will die. So when this happened, Kisa Gotami was the name of this woman, Kisa Gotami. When her kid died, she was going here and there. She wanted that her kid to be brought back to life. And she went to Buddha. Buddha. And Buddha devised, Buddha couldn't say anything. He just said, okay, go and get me some mustard seed. Sarson ke beej, get me mustard seed. But get it from where? That is, get it from that house where not a single death has taken place. And that is not possible. Kisa Gotami realized that there is not at all a single home where death has not taken place. And that's how she understood. But you know, pain is pain. You cannot get off it from your heart or mind. But still, this was a good teaching that everyone has to die. Everyone has to die. Gautam Buddha passed away at what place Gautam Buddha died? It's Kushinara, it's Kushinagar. They both are same. Let me show you here. So all these places are here only. See, this is the Kushinagar or Kushinara. Bodh Gaya, he got enlightened. Near Varanasi, Sarnath, he gave most of his teaching, Updesh, sermons. All beings long to live. That is, all living beings wants to live. Who made this statement? Mahavira. Mahavira, any animal, any insect, or whosoever breathe, they want to live. They have a desire to live. So you can't kill them. Don't kill them. It's beyond the natural, beyond the nature. Right? Who all join the Sangha? So in the Sangha, traders, merchants, people who used to do trades, laborers who used to work, and the slaves of some masters. Zoroaster, Zarathustra was a prophet. So this is what is the indication, Billa indication, or the sign of Zoroastrianism. Zoroaster was a prophet from, prophet means Paigambar, God's messenger. He's from Iran. So all the teachings were written down in Zendavesta, and mostly this Zoroastri, most of the people, they traveled, some of them came to Gujarat and Maharashtra. So we know them, these are Parsis people, Parsis, very good community. Define Avesta, Zend Avesta, the teaching of Zoroaster. So Zoroaster was a prophet, Paigambar, messenger from Iran. So he was the messenger of God. His teachings are written down, contained, or collected in a book, and that is called as Avesta, Zend Avesta. That means good thoughts. He said good thoughts means good words, good thinking, thoughts and thinking. Good work and good deeds. Do everything good, speak good and think good. That is what every religion says actually. Every religion says that thing. No religion says that go and kill this and do bad things, you know. Define Tirthankara, the seeker of truth in Jain religion. Jain, Mahavir. So the seeker of the truth, enlightenment, reality, satya. A seeker of these things in a Jain religion, Tirthankara. Usually, Upanishadic discussions were held by. So, Upanishad, let me tell you the meaning. It means sitting near the God, sitting near your big fellow, sitting near your master, sitting near intelligent people. So, that is called literally means Upanishad. But, Upanishad, most of the thinkers at that time were discussing certain things. That is, what is the essence of life? What's life? Why are we doing these rituals? What will happen to us after life? What is the thing which remains stagnant or permanent here in the world? So all these questions were being discussed, people were debating, coming up with different ideas. So all these discussions were held by Brahmins, mostly Brahmins, because they were intelligent people, still they are. But Rajas were also involved, means Kshatriyas, you can say. But women and poor, the involvement was not at all, or you can say very less. But we'll talk about Gargi, and we have talked about Gargi and Satyakam Jabala. Why Mahavir is called Jina? Mahavira is called Jina. Jina, this means, Jina means I have won. Actually, Mahavir means, Maha means very big, Vir means I am strong, I can win. So Mahavir. So the conquering, for conquering pleasure and pain. That is why Jina. Because you know, in Mahavira, men has to take off all the cloth. And that is how you relieve yourself from the pleasure and the pain. Pleasure and the pain. Mahavir. White clothes were worn by the followers of Jainism and Buddha. So I've seen Jain people, they would wear white dress, and the Buddha will wear the Narangi, Bajrangi, or you can say, you know, Santra type dress. Jainism, white clothes. Name the Brahman teacher who accepted Satyakam Jabala as a student. So I'll take you to that picture. Here, if you see, he is Satyakam Jabala. He was poor, but because, you know, those making this poor person at that era was very difficult, making him as a student. But Maharshi Gautam, he took him as his student, gave him the Brahmanatva. So that is how that is how he became so popular, Satyakam Jabala, as a very good thinker. So Gautam is the answer. Jainism was primarily supported by traders. Because traders wouldn't kill anyone, and all the teachings they can follow, except leaving the home and going in the search of truth. But the farmers cannot do that because they have to kill these insects. So traders is the correct answer here. Traders. Why was Shankaracharya famous? Adi Shankaracharya. So we talked about Upanishad when it was being formed, created as dialogues. Most of the thinkers, it's, you can name some names, Satyakam Jabala, Gargiji, and even Mahavir and Buddha, they also come under thinkers only, because they thought, and what they thought and their thinking was so good that people started following them, and it became a religion. So all these ideas, they was propelled, they was propagated and enhanced by a person called Adi Shankaracharya. So Upanishadic thoughts, the thoughts of which was prevalent in Upanishads, it was propagated, actually spread by Shankaracharya after that. Vardhamana Mahavira asked his followers to strictly follow the doctrine of, path of, doctrine of means path of, what is the path of? Ahimsa, Ahimsa Paramo Dharma. Ahimsa means no violence. Ahimsa means no killing. Ahimsa means no anger. Ahimsa means no hinsa. No hinsa. That is the main idea of Vardhamana Mahavira and the Jainism. No violence. Not even a single insect. Even if the cockroach is coming, or a machar, that is the mosquito, is there, you cannot kill it. That's beyond what Mahavira's teaching is. So if you go to other countries, you know, you will see the pigs and guy, cow are being eaten, dogs are eaten, everything which is moving is eaten. The teachings of Mahavira and his followers are available in the form of Vallabhi. We also saw a question here in Gujarat. Whatever was done or being taught 1500 years ago, all is there, content is there. Both Jain and Buddhist monks rested only in the season of rain. And this is correct because, you know, we have 2 to 3 months of monsoon. And at that time, there were no vehicles like this we have today. Sophistication was not there. So at that time, the movement mainly by walking, it was very difficult. The Zoroastrians who migrated to India are presently known as Parsis. You have heard about Aruna Irani, if not Bowman Irani. All these are Parsis. These people, and you see their face, you'll see they match with the Iranians. Why? Because they have all come, or their roots are from Jamshedji Tata, Ratan Tata. All these are Parsis. They are basically Zoroastrians who migrated to India, Gujarat and Maharashtra. They came. Name the book in which the teachings of Zoroaster, Zarathustra, are contained. Zen the Avesta. Zarathustra or Zoroaster, the book, all his teachings, he was the messenger of the God and he was in Iran. So whatever he has said, the teaching was in Zen the Avesta. Name the place where the Karle or Kale cave is located. So this is in Maharashtra, and this cave is where these monks, nuns, they used to come and stay, because at the time when it was raining or some hard times, they had to live. They had nothing. They just have to do everything with bhiksha, that is, get money and food from other people. So this is an example of that cave where we have evidence that people used to stay there, right? Kale cave in Maharashtra. The picture is also shown in your book. So now we come to the end, and these are two questions for you. If you can answer any one of these, then I assume that you have followed the discussion we had for the chapter and these questions. And these are the questions which are competition question. So if you are able to answer them, it would be very good. Just in the comment section, you can give the answer. So we have discussed them all. And I will give you the answers later, but I would like you encourage you to answer these. Any one of these will do. Okay. So we have done around 50 questions now, and that takes all the chapter, and in between I gave the discussions also. So this is all about this topic. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.